Okay, so now our app is completely ready. So in order to put the data as per our yesterday's class, in order to put some data, you need to first of all, you need to go to this deployment options, deployment credentials, and then you need to reset your username and password, FTP username, file transfer protocol username and password. Then only you can actually connect to that server and you can put your own application data into that server. Then once it is, once you have successfully uploaded, you can actually access that particular application. So as of now, we have some sample application. This will just browse this particular site. So I'm going to say browse. See, the app is up and running. Okay, let's quickly go ahead and see a few more options related to this. Now, we'll see these upgrade and downgrade feature of this particular app service. We have scale up feature, scale up app service plan, which means like whenever you feel this particular plan, whatever the configuration you are using for this app service plan is not sufficient, you feel like you have a huge load, you can actually manually upgrade your upgrade your particular app service plan configurations by coming to the scale up app service plan feature. So let's say I'm currently using S1. So if you want to upgrade that to, currently I'm having 1 core and 1.75 GB RAM. If I want to upgrade that to a different size, I have one more new plan called 1X P1 V2, which has a 1 core and 3.5 GB RAM, and which belongs to a DV2 series compute. And the estimated cost for the month is 9,835. So here you have a couple of options related to it. And if you want that, just select that. And if you say OK, or just apply, automatically your app service will be upgraded from a standard to P1 V2. This is how you upgrade manually. Let's say, as I said in the yesterday's class, we have auto scale feature, which means like whenever we have a load or depends upon the CPU or RAM memory, so automatically it should only do on its own. So then you need to just come to the scale out app service plan option, where you know it has a kind of elastic pool concept, where whenever it, let's say, so I'm just currently taking the instance count. So I'm going to enable the auto scale. So you have a couple of options here in order to select. So scale based on a metric. So this is the option that you actually do it. Now we have a new feature called scale to specific instance count. So let's say if I say only this option, automatically whenever you have, what happens here is if you select this option, your app service is running fine. Whenever you have a huge load on this particular server, automatically, you know, the second duplicate instance will be created with the same replica of this. And then whoever people actually connecting to this app service will be routed to this particular second instance. So this is actually doing by on its own. As I said, it is an auto scale feature, which is completely Microsoft managing it. Okay. So if you just say, if you want to do it scale based on a metric, so, you know, you need to, give me a second, scale out and scale in instead based on a metric, for example. Okay. So I'm just selecting this metric option. So if you select this metric option, instance limit, you can even set the instance limit. Let's say I'm going to say, I need 3 instance max. Minimum is 1. So default is also 1. Currently I have the app service. Now what happens here is I'm going to add some conditions to this. What are the conditions? So if you see here, I just selected some metrics. So in our, first of all, I have selected some metrics here, metrics option, depending upon the metrics, depending upon the CPU or depends upon the memory, if you want to scale out or scale in. So you need to set some rules for this. Just go ahead and select a rule. And then you can select the metric by depending upon which metric you want to actually scale out this particular app service plan. So I'll say CPU percentage, by going with CPU percentage or memory percentage or data in, data out, depends upon these metrics, you can actually select one. Let's say I'm going to say CPU percentage. Whenever my app service plan CPU reaches or average or greater than, let's say 70%, automatically, you know, a second instance will be created. Okay. So as I said, maximum instance limit is 3. So a duplicate instance, like similarly, one more app service plan will be created. They don't have any second URL. Only one URL will be there. Whoever people are actually trying to connect to this app service plan, let's say you have a huge load on this first instance, automatically second instance, so people who are logging in for the second, new people who are logging into that particular instance, so they will be routed to the second instance. That's how the traffic is migrated. So now I'm just saying the threshold as 70%, so it will wait for 10 minutes and still the people are trying to access, new people are actually logging in and still people are trying to access the instance, then it will spin up a new instance. As we said, three is the maximum. Only up to three instances it will create. So cool down minutes, and it will wait for 5 minutes, and if the percentage is less than 70%, and automatically it removes that instance. Let's say it moves those traffic from the second instance to first instance, and it will remove that second instance. So by doing this stuff, it is actually doing some automation task here. So understood, or do you want me to explain via diagrammatically? Okay, I'll just draw some diagram and I'll explain it. So let's say I'm actually creating one app service. So this is my app service, which is like web app. Okay, and this has, obviously this is connected to a, this is connected to a app service plan. I'll say ASP, and it has 1 GB RAM and 1 GB RAM and one CPU. Okay, now and a few storage options are there. So you have these options right now, and this app is connected to this app service plan. Now what happens here is, when we are actually configuring this scale out feature, scale out app service plan option, we have auto scale feature enabled for this. Let's say you are actually setting some rule here. What is the rule? So just, I'm just writing the rule here. Whenever, so there will be a traffic, so that always hits to this machine. So this is the traffic. Depends how many users comes, we can't even predict. So if you just share your username, which is like URL, so URL of your account, so the traffic comes in. So always, you know, traffic will hit your particular application. It may be night time or it may be morning time, it doesn't matter. Depends upon the user logins at particular times. So now, so traffic is coming in. So we are actually setting some rule, stating that, you know, every time you can't check the load, and you can't, every time you can't upgrade manually. Instead of that, we are actually using this particular option called auto scale, scale out feature. We are calling it as scale out feature, scale out app service plan feature, and we are completely automating this process. So what we are setting a rule, we are setting a rule, depends upon, we have two rules here. First one is going with scale out by using metrics. So metric might be CPU percentage or memory percentage or data in or data out. So by depending upon few more options, we are actually setting some rule. And we have a second rule called scale out instance. And here also, we are actually setting some rules here. So what would be the rule, like how many instances you want? Let's say automatically, you know, it doesn't matter with CPU. Here you can actually specify the metric by depending upon which metric you want to scale out the instances. So here you don't have an option to select these particular metrics. So automatically you will say minimum is one, default also will be one, because we have only one app service plan. So maximum you will specify, like three, you want three instances or five instances. So automatically, by depending upon this scale out, so it automatically checks if it reaches above 70%. So Microsoft has a default default values. Whenever it reaches CPU or memory, it reaches 70%, automatically it creates one more instance within fraction of seconds, and it moves that traffic. This traffic will be moved to second instance. Second instance, assume that second instance is here. So this is a clone of it, which means a copy of that machine. You have the same data available in this application. So whatever the traffic it is coming in, it actually tries to move to this particular instance, so that it manages the load. And instead of making this app service very busy, So this will move the traffic to this particular application. Let's say after 5 or 10 minutes, your complete load is down, which means like, you know, no users are logging into this. So it will wait for 5 minutes, and if there is no traffic, then it slowly, let's say it doesn't depend upon this machine, as we have configured the auto scale for this machine, it will check. So if the CPU reaches less than 70% for 5 minutes, then automatically this will kill, this kills this particular instance, and then automatically the traffic will be routed to this particular app. So who is doing this? Microsoft is actually managing this by using this auto scale. Whenever you configure this auto scale, Microsoft will take care of everything. So this is a piece of automation. Even you can write some automation scripts. So earlier versions, whenever we are using the app service plans in 2012, so we don't have these auto scale for that. So we need to write some piece of script for that and in order to do this stuff. But nowadays Microsoft has implemented this option in the portal itself. So this is the benefit by using this. And as I said, as you are actually using some automation option here, so Microsoft is actually creating an instance for you, and it is routing the traffic. So it is doing some backend work for you. So this option is a little bit costly when you are actually going with this option. It depends when customers will use this option is whenever the application is in production. So they will go with this application. They will go with this auto scale feature. So once it is configured, no support engineer required to monitor this particular application 24/7. So automatically it automatically scales up and scales down. Let's say whenever you have the connectivity issues on this app service, then you need to troubleshoot. Okay, so this is how the auto scale feature works. So now I'm just specifying it and I'm saying yes, save. Where to auto scale configuration service plan and update auto. Okay, issue with the app service plan. Just let's check that. At least one scaling ruler. Okay, let me go here.
How come they know that the traffic is more or less?
That's what we can actually track it from the application inside. I'll show you that. Okay, so what are the benefits that you get with the S1 plan? If you see here, currently I'm just taking S1 plan. S1 plan has all these options. I can actually configure custom domains and SSL certificates. I can even auto scale up to 10 instances. I have a maximum capacity of 10 instances auto scale feature. Staging slots available, daily backups available, traffic manager I can configure. I can even configure the storage up to 50 GB. And memory per instance available to run application. Application deployed and running. So this is for developers, and CPU, dedicated A series compute resource. So these are all the features that I'm getting with this particular S1 size. So I'm good with it. But why the error message? We'll just cross check that. I'm going back to the scale out feature once again. So scale out app service plan. So I'm going to say instance count to 2. Scale out and scale in your instance based on your metrics. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just saying add rule maximum. I'll say 5. At least one scaling rule. What was that scaling rule? We have that. No, that's true. We have added it, but when we are creating it, it is showing some error. Current resource, yeah. Current resource is our app service plan. We are actually configuring this scale out for the app service plan only. Okay, this is fine. CPU percentage we are taking. I'm just taking now 2%. Just say 2. I'll just take 0.5. Don't wait for 5 minutes. I'll say 2 minutes. 2 minutes is not accepted. Okay, 5 minutes. So increase count by one and cooldown time, I'll say. Okay, to accept it. Add. This is failing, that's the problem. Failure to update auto scale configuration for servers. What's wrong with this? Absolutely. Region doesn't matter. Okay. So auto scale setting name it is asking. Okay. I'm just setting as auto scale. Okay. Save. Okay. Every time it actually takes, you know, earlier we whenever we create auto scale options, so it takes as auto scale 1, auto scale 2, auto scale 3, but nowadays it is even asking us the name. Okay, cool. So once this is configured, so this is properly configured, what I'll do here is, as I said, so every let's say CPU goes above 5%, automatically a new instance should be created. Let's see how this is happening. Now what is our we'll go to the metrics and we'll see. I'm going to the overview blade, just scrolling completely right, and here if you scroll down you have the metrics here available. So here you have only data in and data out. So just click on this option, you will be routed to this metrics overview blade. So instead of that, even you can scroll down and you come to the monitoring section. So mobile, yeah, monitoring section, you have this log stream, right? Just you can even go to that log stream and you can explore that particular metric. So currently, application logs are switched off, or you can turn on application logs. Okay, so where is our application inside? We can directly track it from there. Do one thing. Overview. Scroll down. Average response time request. I'll just click on this. Now I am under the metric section, where I'll just go with a new mode which was launched by Microsoft. So I'm just clicking on this. So this is a new way of accessing your request. So I'm going to add one more alert, add a filter, and now I'll say instance. See, if you see, select a value. Currently you have two instances available. So when I say diamond instance here, two instances I can see. So let's go to the auto scale feature and let's see that where it got deployed. Just going back to scale out. Okay, they have. Wait a second. So we have configured this auto scale feature. Earlier you have a preview window here, how many instances currently running. As I said, maximum is 5, but currently it is not showing the preview window. Maybe the changes has happened in the portal, Azure portal, the preview window is gone. But when you go to the metrics section, when you select the instance, automatically it is showing the two instances names. Like, as I have only app service plan, one app service plan in the subscription, as it is showing the two instances. So how can you see that? Just go back to the overview and come to the right hand side, and here you have the metric section. Just click on any one of it and we'll see what is the current CPU. So here currently this data out is selected. I'm going to say CPU average CPU memory average response time. What was that? CPU time. I don't need a CPU time. Okay, I'll go with the new metrics. So I have here a CPU connections, average response time, average memory working set. IO read and write. IO input output per second. How many inputs actually that app is receiving and how many outputs that is sending back. You can actually track the IOs. So select the CPU. So the current CPU time. Okay. MS, this is time. Where is the CPU? I have access CPU percentage, average response time. No, I don't require time. It's a max. Data in. Select. Yeah, CPU percentage. I have to select the app service plan, then I'll get the CPU percentage. Currently, we are actually accessing that application here. So we have some load on that particular CPU percentage is 30% right now. Sorry. So currently it is only, you know, 0%, but whenever initially when we have created automatically the load, it is showing as 35%. Due to that reason, it has automatically it has created some instances. How can you track those? Just go to and select auto scale feature. And here you have metrics for that auto scale. So currently as of now, it is 0%. It is not showing anything, but we have set the auto scale feature. If it actually waits for 5 minutes, and if it is beyond, sorry, 5% beyond, if it is beyond 5%, automatically it creates one more instance. So we'll see that where was that instance. So give me a second. Absolute plan. So earlier when I just opened this page, automatically it showed some instances count here. So let me select the instances. Where was that? This plan. Yeah, it got zero. That's the reason now only one. Right. So we'll try to put some load or do some performance testing on this. When the second Surendra, your question is what about the data when the second VM is deleted? Where will the logs and store? So it's not like a second VM. It's like instance, you know. Instance is like similarly like a one more app service which is being managed by Microsoft. Each and every logs, each and everything will be stored in the application inside. So you have a tool. This is a monitoring tool just in order to check the health of the particular app service plan. But in order to trace the logs and everything, then you need to enable the diagnostics features here. So if you just come down, you have this option here called you know, monitoring. So here you have a diagnostics logs, which means like you have to enable all these, if you want application related logging, log, so if you want web server log, so everything, each and every kind of logs, if you want to see failed traces, you can just enable all this stuff. And then, but it needs some storage account in order to store all these logs. So you just need to configure one storage account. And then if you just click on save, automatically all the logs will be dumped into that storage account. So whenever you want, you can actually trace those logs. Or I can go with application insight. Application insight doesn't require any storage account. So let me quickly go ahead and show you that. So if you go to this, so application insight is the latest Microsoft feature, which actually it's a completely brilliant and intelligent tool. It monitors and it do some analytics for you instead of, you know, manually going to the storage account or manually digging that log. So it actually does for you. So what you need to do is just go ahead and configure the application insight. So I have created application insight along with this particular app service. I'm just selecting that, and what I'm doing here is I'm just saving as apply. Just say okay. Okay, now I'm going to say okay. Runtime framework, I'll say ASP.NET. My application has ASP.NET, and what I will do is, so go to advanced. So these all options will be default on. So okay, I'll say okay now. Whenever I configure my application inside with this app service plan, instead of saving all the logs and maintaining one more storage account and paying for the storage, you can actually use this app service plan, sorry, application inside, and you can configure all the stuff. So what happens if you configure this? You can actually track each and everything on time. So I'll show you that quickly. Continue. So now application insight is actually configuring to this particular app service plan. Okay, this is configured. One second, it is not showing now.
This window became very small for me.
Whenever you are setting this option, this application needs a restart when you are configuring an application inside with your app service. So I'm going to say continue. Okay, now application insights got created. Okay, now if you see this window, but it should go. Why this is still popping up? So if you see here, your application insight is getting configured for your particular app service. So it will it automatically pulls the application logs. It tries to pull everything from your app service, and once it will show you the logs clearly on this application insight window. Let us go back to application insight now. Go to all service. Either you can select from the all service or and go to say application insights. Selected the application insights. Okay. So here, this is the tool where you actually monitor your application. Currently, I have configured our application to this particular particular application insight. So I'm going to see this performance. If you want to track all the performance related stuff, or if you want to see the metrics, if you want to see live metrics, let's say how many users are connected on live right now. So if you want to see that stuff, you can actually go through this option and you can track those options from this particular tool. So this is our live metrics screen where you can see the app related live metrics here. Incoming request, outgoing request, server health, everything you can track it here. So who is going to use this particular application in real time? PE, performance engineering team, will use this application. Let's say whenever they face any issues of connecting to this, but are pulling the logs from the application, from the app service, they will actually report to you as a support engineer. So they'll say like, hey, support team, I'm unable to view some logs to the app service plan. Just go ahead and check whether this is properly configured or not. Then your task is to go to the app service and you need to check whether this is properly associated with it. So every application insight has some instrumentation key. So you see this here, you have application insight key. So you should check whether this application insight is key is properly configured or not. So where can you see that? Go to the app service plan. If that key is properly configured with this app service plan, app service, then only you can actually pull the logs. So I'm going to the application settings here. Under these application settings, so if you see here, I'm going just scrolling down. Yep, here you have this application instrumentation key. This key is properly configured. I have not given this key, but how this key has appeared here, because I have just gone through the application insight here and I have added that application insight to this app service. So once you have done that, automatically this application settings will get updated and the key will be properly configured. That's the reason whenever I'm just going to that particular application inside, I can see the logs related to this particular app. Yes, Raj, you need to do it for every single application you do, because this is a PaaS component. It needs this application inside, because Microsoft is actually recommending you to create this application inside for each and every app service. Even let's say if you want, you can even configure three app services, one single insight. So the app services can be configured with a single insight. But when you are actually digging, so let's say when performance engineering team is actually digging the logs, you know, during that time, it may be some messy things. So they need to customize all the options and they need to select proper app service, and then they need to pull out the logs. So that's the reason, as this is not a very costly application. So in real time, each and every customers, they start using this application insight for each and every app service. Let's say I'm currently having one app service called Visual Path 1. So I can actually take one more application inside for this and I can create it. So it's not a very costly application, right? So that's the reason. So you are actually, everyone bothers about the monitoring and performance of their applications. So in order to fix those, you need this app service, application insight, so that you can properly track the logs and everything. Okay, so we'll quickly go back to the scale out feature and we'll see whether we have any new instances got created or not. So not here, sorry. I'm going back to the metrics overview. I'm going to say filter. See, we have an instance count here now. So if you see here, we have two instances. So we don't know where we are and which instance is main instance. It's not a problem, okay? Everything is being managed by Microsoft and logs are being triggered to that storage account, or if you are using application inside, it will be logs are stored in the application inside. So it doesn't matter with the instances count. Just you, in order to make your app is running up and online 24/7, you are actually using this auto scale feature. Okay, so that's the reason it's showing up now. Currently I'm going to say supported by metrics. Okay, refresh. Filters, additional filters, I'll go with these are the live metrics. These are the live metrics. Let's say if you want to see the status of the one instance, you can actually see that. As I said, only metric percentage is just 5% I have given. So every time, you know, it actually go, the instance will be created and instance will be removed. So it should not be like that in real time. You have to set that instance CPU percentage threshold should be always 70% or above 65%. Then only this instance will be stable and this metrics tool can properly pull the logs from that instance. Currently, as I have said, only 5%, it is actually removing the instance and creating the instance. That's the reason we are not getting the logs back. So it is not even staying for 5 or 10 minutes. You know, that's the reason we are not getting the logs properly. So this is how you configure a scale out feature for this particular app service. And we'll go to this application inside and we'll explore a few more options. Meanwhile, do I miss anything here? So we need to cover a couple of options also here. So backups, as I said, backups you need to cover these custom domains by changing the name of this particular app service, visualpath.com. So I need to check that and I need to tell SSL certificate binding also. So we'll cover that topic as well. So one more important topic, as I said, app service has a zero downtime facility called deployment slots. So we need to cover this topic also. We'll do that. So we are done with scale in and scale out feature for today. And we'll see these web jobs. Web jobs are purely used by the developers, guys. You don't need to bother about this. So whoever using the .NET applications or Java applications, they need these web jobs. Okay. So it's not mandatory to have a web job in your particular app service. So you can completely ignore this. So you may ask a question, how can I connect a SQL database to this particular app service? You just go to the application settings, you have an option of connection string. So here you have a connection strings. I'm just going down. Okay. So here, if you go down, you have option of connection string. Yeah. Connection string. If you click on add a connection string, you can select which type of server you are actually trying to connect. So I'm going to just say SQL server. Or SQL Azure, SQL Server in the sense like on your own server. Like it is SQL Azure, which means like if it is SQL one, which is hosted on Azure platform, you can give it. So you can just specify the name and this is the value section and this is the name. So you have four SQL servers. You can give the SQL server name here and the value. Value is the connection string, proper connection string. It has a username and passwords. So it is a separate command. Okay. In tomorrow's session, we'll cover that part, how to connect. I'll create a sample SQL database in front of you and we'll try to connect that SQL database to this particular app service. And what we have missed. So development tools, and one more thing here is, you know, you can actually ignore these development tools, guys. These are all purely used by the developers. Clone app, console, advanced tools in the sense Kudos. So this is what I actually mean to say yesterday. So this site is purely used by the application support team or a development, as we are the infrastructure support team. So we don't manage this, but anyhow, you should be aware of it. So currently your application name is visualpath.azure.com. So give me a second. Are there any sizes metrics for the new out there? Say optimum values based on number of process memory, etc. Calculations for this. For the VMs, it's Raj, it's not a VM actually. This is app services, which is a purely a PaaS component. Microsoft actually manages each and every piece of software, a piece of thing related to it. Okay. Are there any sizing metrics for the VMs? Yes, actually, we are actually, whenever we are configuring the scale out feature, we are adding a rule called CPU or RAM. Okay. Whenever you are specifying a CPU, we are only giving the value of threshold, saying 70% CPU. Let's say if this particular app service reaches 70%, we are just telling that rule as, you know, create a one more instance. So that's called as a threshold. We are setting the threshold in the configurations itself. Okay. We are giving the metric value, proper value. So based on the number itself, we are giving the process and memory. So either you can only select one metric at a time. Let's say if you want to select CPU percentage, you can only select one metric. So if you want to select a memory metric also, then you need to add a one more rule in the scale out feature. Okay. That's how it works. Now, as I was talking about, this is a Kudu site. So you call this as Kudu site, or, you know, application support team will only have the access. So if you see the name visualpath.scm.com. So in order to access this application, you can just come to the development tools. You have the advanced tools, go here and you can actually access that. Or you have a one more method call, you know, you have one more method here, go to the overview blade. So you have a publish, get published profile option. So this is the actual method. So everyone, whoever click on that advanced tools and Kudu's page, everyone can't access this page. This is a restricted site where you can actually, you know, whatever, you can actually see the server details here. So this is our app service backend server details. So Azure app service details and site up from this time, and you can actually access the root folder. You can actually enter backend, you are actually accessing it. App service backend. So this is only access. This is only available for the admins who are admins for this app service plan. Or let's say I have given access only for you as a contributor. Even you have this permissions to access this particular page. So let's say I'm a reader for this app service. I can't, when I click on this link, this doesn't work for me. So in order to access that, you should have username and password. What I will do here is I'll just download this get published profile thing and I'll open with my notepad. I'll say notepad and I'll open it. So in this, so I was talking about the URL. So this is the URL, SCM dot. So there is a one more word added, scm.azurewebsites.net. So this is your URL and that guy needs to use this username, and here he has the password. So whenever he enters these credentials, then only he can able to access this particular site. It's not, we are not going to share these credentials because this is completely backend of that particular app. Let's say whoever having the access directly, they can access the root directory and they can do changes in the application. So I'm inside this debug console. When I can even go with command prompt or PowerShell commands. This is the window here, but directly I'm going to the root directory sites. So www root, yesterday we have, so I have showed you how to put some data into this. So this is the default page I have. So if I directly, I can go here and I can do some changes. I can by clicking on edit button. So currently I have only sample data. If I want, I can remove this and I can do changes here. So as I said, this is completely a backend. So most of the people won't have the access. As a support engineer, you will have the access to it. If you want to access to it, download the get published profile, username and password, you have to enter, and the URL. So you need to use that from the notepad file. So restrictions, how you will get it? As I am the owner, I'm having the owner permissions on this particular account. So I'm able to access this Kudu site whenever I click on the developer tools. So whenever I click on the advanced tools and when I'm clicking on it, automatically, you know, I'm able to access that. But it doesn't happen in real time. So in order to access it, you need to download the get published profile. What is this get published profile? Published profile has the SCM credentials and username and passwords. Every time, let's say this is shared with some team, you don't want them to access, then you can reset these credentials. So the credentials will be changed. That's how you know you can make these apps very secure. Now, performance test. So PE team in essence, performance engineering team will do this testing on this particular application. Even you can also run some performance testing. Performance testing is nothing but sending some fake load to this particular app and testing the load, whether your app is stable or getting down. If you are sending some 100 users at a time. So if you want, we can even run that. I'll say new, and now I'm going to say the URL of this app. So this is our URL, visualpath.azurewebsites.net. I'll say done. And test name is perf test one. And this app is hosted on central US web application. General load form. Okay. So from where, which location you want to send the load? So I'm going to say East US. Okay. So users load, I'll say 250 users at a time, and duration minutes, I don't want for 5 minutes. I'll say for 1 minute. Okay. I'll say for 2 minutes, run test. So now test is getting created and then it starts sending some 250 users load to this particular app service. We can track that load from the overview metric. So let's wait whether this is not created yet. It's creating. So this will show you the status here. So this options you don't manage, but for only testing purpose, I'm just showing you for your knowledge. Let's say if you are actually doing some POC or if you are actually testing some application, you need to send these kind of fake logs, fake load to the app, and you need to test it. So this is queued right now, and we'll wait and see the status. So 2 minutes it will run, and then within 2 minutes it sends some 250 concurrent users, and after that it will, you know, if this is completely completed, then we can go to the logs and we can check how our app service and how much CPU it is taking, and depends upon that we can analyze. Okay, so 250 users, the standard S1 is not sufficient. So in order to fix that, you need to upgrade the plan or you need to auto scale this. So that's how you come to the assumption, and the management will take decisions accordingly, depends upon this load test. So who is going to do is PE team, performance engineering, will do the testing on it, load test on it, and then they'll share the report with the management. Accordingly, management will suggest you, they will create a new support request with you, and they will ask you to upgrade this app service plan to so and so configuration. So I'm going back. So better test is loading meanwhile. Just click on this. I'll select the app service plan. Oh, sorry, this was broken. But I don't want all this stuff. I'll just say app service plan. CPU percentage. So if you see here, the percentage started increasing. And if you want to track the real-time traffic, then you need to go to the application insight tool. So here only you can only see some few options only, like CPU percentage, how much data it is coming in, how much data out, and how many request memory percentage you can track. So this is a memory percentage. Memory is going up. It is near almost like 50 to 60% nearby. So 2 minutes, maybe 2 minutes is over. I think seems like the CPU has gone down. Now this is completely like 1%, and memory is also decreasing. It came to 38%. So we'll go back to this application insight and we'll track it. I'm going back to application insight. So this tool will give you a proper information instead of that normal metrics. Where was that? Let me go to all service. I'm just selecting this. So performance. You can go to metrics or you can go to live metrics. You can track the status. So we'll see the metrics count. So if you see here, not available, your app is offline or using older SDK. So this should be fixed by the development team. ASP.NET SDK file is old one. So they need to update the SDK file. So it is not in your hand to do it. Or as I said, Kudu site will be managed by application team. Who will fix this is if you come to the site extensions here. So you have this application inside configured here. So I'm just clicking on that launch application. Just this is only for your information. You are not going to do it. This application team, application support team will take care of this particular thing. So I'm going to fix this error actually. Not available, our app is offline, but in fact our app is up and running. So even still it is pulling the metrics, but it is showing this error message. So in order to fix it, we're going to see, you have this application inside SDK status. SDK status is cannot retrieve application inside attached status. Either the web application is not running or some error has occurred during it. So seems like there is issue with the application inside SDK file, SDK, software development kit. So which is associated with the .NET framework, ASP.NET framework. So this is the version of it is 2.2, 2.0 or later. So you need to fix it with by speaking with the development team. Just you have an option to raise a support request with the development team. You need to raise just take a screenshot of it and send an email or support request to the development team. They will fix it and they'll reply you back. So then onwards you can actually track your logs from this particular application. So this is the live stream and live metrics that you track from this application. So any doubts as of today related to the scale out, scale in future or the metrics part? Metrics, I know it is real a little bit confusing for you, but just do some hands-on experience. Just try to create one app service and try to configure this application insight and pull out some metrics and let me know if you face any difficulties in tomorrow's class so that we can discuss for first 10 minutes or 15 minutes and we can resolve your doubts. Is that Kudu site has something to do with SEM in deployment prospective also? Where will the link deployed to say deployment tools to Azure? So Kudu site, Kudu site is completely a software configuration management tool where application, we can clearly say that application support team or application team will actually manage this Kudu site, not the infrastructure support team. We are actually, as I'm teaching you 7533, we are actually infrastructure support team. So we don't manage this Kudu site, but in fact, there are some scenarios. If you just join a startup company, in that scenario, you need to manage this Kudu site also. So in that scenario, I just showed you how to access this Kudu site and what are the options that you have. Okay. So also, where will be the link deployment tools to Azure? I didn't get you this point. So can you please repeat it, Raj? How will we link SEM tools? Jeff, in case. So SEM tools, you want to link SEM tools to the Azure? No, you directly use this app service plan. Okay, Jeff, okay. In that scenario, you use this URL. So what we call this as, visualpath.sem.azure.websites.net. This is the Kudu's URL. You use this URL and then you configure it. And if you want the username and password, you need to get it from the application team. So if you see here, so we have, as I said, you need to use the published profile. Published profile has the Kudu site username and password. So from that, you can actually get it. But in real time, as Microsoft Azure has also a DevOps concept, there you use Visual Studio Team Services. Okay, we are not using anymore. We are not using Chef or Ansible or Puppet or these kind of tools. So we are using this VSTS, Visual Studio Team Services. So there, as this is a piece of VSTS belongs to Microsoft, so it is completely integrated with this particular account. So it doesn't require a published profile. It automatically pulls that published profile and it has the username and password. It directly can access this Kudos page. Okay. So this is a kind of advanced tool for your job. So just go through that VSTS. Even you can, for your free trial also, you can actually create a VSTS tool and you can get some hands-on experience. Okay. Cool. So any doubts? So online days, I think we are good. So. So online guys, if you have any doubts, you can directly ping me, or let's say if you don't have, then we can wind up for today. And Saturday also we have a class. We'll connect and we'll also see more options on this metrics, because as I have told many things on metrics today, so this might be a little bit confusing for you. We'll see that this monitoring on Saturday. So it's not like early morning, we'll just take a little bit late, as Saturday is a weekend. So I will come at 9 o'clock or something, depends upon the feasibility of everyone. I'll just check your times feasibility on Friday, and once, as per your confirmation, we'll go ahead and take a session on Saturday, like 9 o'clock or 10 o'clock. It's your wish, guys. Okay.
Videos
leva. Permission. Okay, guys. Thank you. Timings, I'll just inform you, Raj. Cool. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.